Welcome to the Business Central Lounge event and our session about using of enforced digital vouchers in Business Central, where my colleague Arthur and I will try to explain in which situation you can use it, as well as how to use and not to be surprised with some of new features. Agenda is really short for today. We will make some introduction to understand the background for this effort. And after that, we will show how you can activate a feature and how to set up to work properly. And of course, some examples how it works in a practice. Okay, let's start. First, introduction about vouchers and especially digital vouchers in the accounting world. In accounting, a voucher is a document or record that provides evidence of financial transaction. Voucher serves support documentation for various financial activities, and there are different types of vouchers used in accounting, each serving specific purpose, for example, receipt vouchers, payment vouchers, credit or debit voucher, purchase or sales voucher, and so on and so on. Now, about digital vouchers. In accounting, it refers to electronic or digital documents that serves as evidence of financial transactions. You can see only this small difference. This is electronic or digital document. It is essentially the electronic equivalent of traditional paper voucher or receipt, and it helps us providing full audit trail. Using this way, it can help companies to be more efficient and being in paperless manner. As I explained earlier, it can be applicable to different type of documents, and how you will use the format of digital vouchers, it is only on your company rules. Except there are requirements by authorities, so you must behave related with them. In digital age, it is more and more desirable to have, even if this is not enforced by the law. But this is something we can expect to come from more and more countries, that newer countries will afford digital vouchers to prevent frauds and easier get full audit trail. This complete approach can even help us. And why and how? Even in some situations where users must upload documentation, there are many places where document can be created from records you have in your system. So we can automate creation of digital vouchers and automatically attach them from the moment when they are created to the record without any manual work. And now, what is difference between attachments in digital vouchers and why we are talking about digital vouchers, as we already have attachments in a Business Central? What is difference here? In general, the main difference is that attachments are based on voluntary usage, and they can be used in many places, not only connected with accounting, but many, many different places. You can use on a customer card, on a job card, many, many different places. On the other side, digital vouchers are accounting category. And in a Business Central, if you set up, they will be mandatory for specific type of documents. So users don't have an option if they want or do not want to attach them. And as I mentioned a couple of times, it can help providing full paperless audit trail in accounting, as you can choose for which documents or journals you want to enforce usage. And yes, as I already said, we added great automation where it is possible to automatically create digital vouchers based on transaction type. This idea came from Danish authorities' requirements with their new bookkeeping act, but this feature can be used in other countries as well. So we decided to create this app as a global app. This is on users to decide to activate and to configure where to enforce digital vouchers if they want it at all. Now let's make a close look. To enable this functionality, you will have guided wizard to enable it. During this process, you can set up entries you want to use. There are different entry types you can choose to set up, such as sales documents, purchase documents, or a few different types of journals. And for each of these entries, you can choose what kind of control you want to configure. By control, we are thinking about enforcing. If you choose no check to keep it out of control, so vouchers will not be enforced. Attachments as only digital file is acceptable as a voucher. That means you must attach some of files. Then attachments plus invoice, the same as previous, but adding electronic document as well. And attachment or note, that means you have an option to upload a file, or if you do not want to use file, just to add some note for this record. That means you can control whatever you want. If you don't want to use voucher somewhere, you can just easily choose no check. If you want to use vouchers, you need to choose one of three additional options. And to clarify, setup depends on what users want or companies want, except in Denmark, where users cannot disable enforcing mandatory vouchers in purchase and sales transactions from January next year. Okay, when you set up enforcing, except for check type, you have two additional important options for each of entries. You can choose an option generate automatically if digital vouchers needs to be generated automatically. This is, for example, especially big help in sales documents. That means when you post your sales invoice, system will automatically create sales invoice document and attach it to this transaction. But you can also choose skip if manually added option. With enabling this option, the automatically generated digital voucher will not be added to the record if manual attachments have already been added. This is on users how they want to use this option. That means even if this is something automatically created, if you decide to manually upload, it can be your choice. You can choose if you want to keep both of these documents on only manually added. And to add one more option, you saw previously five entry types where you can enforce users, and maybe you can say this is not enough to provide full choice for some specific documents where you want to use, but not to all. This is especially case in journals, because you can use journals in various different situations. So because of that, we added additional setup where you can add specific source code for enforcing. So now you can, for example, enforce users to have digital vouchers in general journal, but only if the source code is, for example, payroll or something similar. Okay, I think demo speaks better than thousands of words, so my colleague Artur will show you how it works in the practice. Artur?
I'm going to cover three scenarios. As Alexandru explained from the setup, we're going to have a setup for the sales document. The check type will be attachment, and I have it generate automatically. It means that if there is no attachment by the user, I'm going to generate this report automatically. For the purchase document, we have the check type of attachment, and that means that the user has to attach the document. And then the third scenario will be sales journal, when we don't have any check. So if user do not attach any digital voucher, he still will be able to post the document. Let's start with the purchase document. I'm going to create a new purchase invoice. Specify all the necessary fields. And then I will try to post the document without attaching any digital voucher. And when I do this, I can see the error message that it's not possible to post without attaching the digital voucher. So in order to post, I need to go to the incoming document files fact box and click attach file. Here I need to select file from my local box. I can see the file attached, and then I can continue with posting. The document is posted now, and I can see my file attached in the incoming document files fact box, and also I can see my file connected to the general ledger entry. So I go to the find entries, general ledger entry, and I can still can see the same fact box in common document files. And this file will be connected to every single GL entry. Let's now try to do the same with the sales invoice. I want to create a new sales invoice. And then I don't want to attach any document, but I want them to create automatically. So when I post the document, I would not see any error message and the document is posted successfully. But where is my digital voucher? And the digital voucher is attached to the incoming document file. And when I open the digital voucher, I can see that this is the report automatically generated for this one and attached to posted sales invoice. And in the same way, like for purchase invoice, I can see that the digital voucher is connected to GL entry for every single GL entry. And the latest scenario that will be covered is the sales journal. For the sales journal, I don't have a setup that enforces me to attach digital voucher. So if I go to the sales journal and if I want to create an invoice for the customer, and I want to post this invoice without attaching any document, there will be no error. So I can post the document without digital voucher. Alexander?
Okay, thank you, Artur, this great demo. And this is shortly what we wanted to show you for it, these features. Now, I would like to say thank you for watching this session about enforcing digital vouchers and BC Launch event. We will be on a date of BC Launch event, both of us will be there, so we will be open for questions and answers, so you can ask us everything what is not so clear from this presentation. Before we finish for today, I would like to invite you for some additional sessions somehow connected with this topic. One of them is what is new related with new Danish Bookkeeping Act, because this feature will be one part of all requirements for Danish Bookkeeping Acts, and what is new legislation localization in Business Central. And again, before we finish, if you are missing some of information for Business Central, just go to some of these links and you can find many interesting things. If you cannot remember all of them, minimum try to not to forget AKMSBCall, so you can find all these important links there. Once more, thank you in my and Artur name.